Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmanov from veenaasmanov.com. I hope you all are doing well. I have another quick and easy recipe for you today. These are my buttery soft crescent rolls. We make them from scratch, and the best part is that you do not have to knead the dough. It's a very simple, easy, no-knead recipe, and I think you're going to love it. Don't forget, you will get all the recipe ingredients below this video or on my blog, and I'll leave the link below. Let's start by making the yeast mixture. I've got warm milk, yeast, sugar. Now this is a little sweet dough, so I have 4 tablespoons of sugar, but you can reduce that as well. I've got eggs. I'm going to give that a good mix, and then I'm going to add half the flour and some salt. Now you don't want to mix the salt directly into your yeast, so I'm going to mix it into my flour first. And you see, I just use a whisk to get it all together, and now I'm going to add a little more flour. I'm going to continue to mix this with a spatula, and you see that's quite soft dough. I'm going to add the room temperature butter. It is very important that the butter is room temperature, otherwise it will not incorporate. And I'm going to use my hands because I just like to use my hands when I'm making my dough, but you can continue to use with a spatula. This is a very soft dough. You see how soft that is? Now I'm going to put a cling wrap, and I'm going to let this rest in on the counter for about 60 to 90 minutes until it's double. Once it's double in size, I'm going to put it into the fridge for 60 minutes. It is very important that you chill the dough, otherwise the sticky dough is going to be very difficult to roll. You see this? I'm going to give this a knead for about 30 seconds. You see the dough is chilled, so it's easier for me to work with it. Now I'm going to divide this into two, and I'm going to roll this into a 12-inch disc. Now you can make 24 crescents out of this. Okay, I'm going to just roll this up. Now while rolling, if you find that the dough is not rolling out and it's resisting, that's the word, and you just want to make sure that you leave the dough alone for just about 5-10 minutes, so the gluten relaxes and the dough starts working with you again. Okay, so now I've got some butter. I'm going to give this a nice smear of butter because we want our crescent rolls to be nice and buttery. So again, if you don't want to put the butter, you are free to omit it, but I like having a little bit of my kids love this bread, so I like to give them a nice buttery soft crescent rolls. Now I'm going to divide this into 12, and it's very simple. I'm just going to cut across and across, and then I'm going to cut each of these into 3, and it's very simple. Now, I'm not measuring, but if you want, you can go ahead and measure it. I like to wing it a little bit, and a pizza cutter is actually the best thing to use for these things because it's easier with the dough, especially because yeast dough has the stretching element. I'm going to put all these aside so I can actually work one at a time. Okay, now all we need to do is roll. See, from the thick side towards the tip. Okay, I'm going to roll all these just like that. Can you see how simple and easy this dough is? I mean, you don't have to knead it, and then it's just like this, and it looks so pretty. Now I'm not really so fast. I fast forwarded the video so just so that I don't bore you watching me. And that's it. Now I'm going to let these again proof for about 45 minutes on a baking tray. Okay, you want to make sure that you give them a little bit of space in between, because they will not become too big. They will proof a bit and become a little bit bigger. So about 45 minutes. At about 30 minutes, you will start preheating your oven so that we can egg wash them and bake them. And here you go. You see they're all almost double in size. Now I have an egg, beaten egg with 2 tablespoons of water. I'm going to give that a good mix and then use it to brush my crescent rolls. You can also use just egg white, but egg white doesn't really give you a nice golden color. The egg yolks actually give you a nice golden color for your crescent rolls, so I highly recommend the egg yolk, the whole egg. Now these are going to go into my preheated oven for about 12 to 15 minutes. Mine took about 15 minutes, but if your oven is hot, it might take even up to just 12 minutes. Now as soon as these are come outside, I'm going to brush these with melted butter, just butter, room temperature butter, and they will melt on the hot bun rolls. I'm going to also put a cloth on, clean kitchen cloth on top of this so that is they stay nice and soft. The best way to keep rolls soft is to actually let the steam stay in there so that the moisture stays inside the roll and it stays softer. Okay, so that's our crescent rolls all done, and you see we didn't need them, and it's such a simple and easy recipe to make. I'm going to break one and show you how beautiful they are inside, and I hope you try this recipe. And look at that, soft, very light, very airy, and absolutely delicious and buttery. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and of course subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me. If you do try my recipe, I'd love it if you can tag me, hashtag Veena Asmanov, so I can see it as well. I'll see you in another video. Bye-bye for now.